हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम इम्पॉर्टेंट प्रीवियस मेंस एग्जाम क्वेश्चंस। ओके, नाउ द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग रिवर्सिबल केमिकल रिएक्शंस, ए टू प्लस बी टू इक्विलिब्रियम टू ए बी एंड नंबर टू सिक्स ए बी इक्विलिब्रियम थ्री ए टू प्लस थ्री बी टू। सो द equilibrium constants are K1 and K2 respectively. Now the question is relation between K1 and K2. Now here, first of all, equation 1. What is the equation 1? A2 plus B2. Equilibrium टू ए बी। वाट इज द इक्विलिब्रियम कॉन्स्टेंट हियर गिवन? के वन। नाउ वाट आई एम डूइंग, आई एम इंटरचेंजिंग रिएक्टेंट्स एंड प्रोडक्ट्स। व्हेन अ रिएक्शन इज व्हेन अ रिएक्शन इज रिवर्सड, द इक्विलिब्रियम कॉन्स्टेंट बिकम रेसिप्रोकल। एस आर नो? आफ्टर दैट वी हैव द स्टाइकोमेट्रिक कोएफिशिएंट हियर 6, but here where the stoichiometric coefficient is only 2. So now we have to raise the stoichiometric coefficient 2 to 6 by multiplying with the suitable integer 3. So next time multiplying with the 3 on both sides, 6ab 3a2 3b2. Then whatever the equilibrium constant value, whatever the factor you are multiplying, that factor will be raised to the power of the previous equilibrium constant. Okay, now which is equal to 1 by k1 cube. Already this equation equilibrium constant given in the question as a k2 is given as a k2. That means the k2 value now equal to 1 by k1 whole cube. K2 value equal to 1 by K1 whole cube, otherwise K1 to the power minus 3, according to which option C is the correct one. Option C will be the correct. Yes or no? Option C is the right answer. Okay, very simple problem. This is last year 2019 online question paper. Okay, chemical equilibrium chapter. Now come to next online question paper last year. The values of Kp divided by Kc for the following reactions at 300 Kelvin respectively. RT value given to you 24.62 decimeter cube atm per mole. Now what is the first equation? N2 plus O2 equilibrium 2NO. Now, first of all, identify the delta NG. What is the delta NG? Sum of the number of moles of gaseous products minus sum of the number of moles of gaseous reactants, which is equal to 2 minus 2, that is 0. Now, what is the relation between Kp and Kc? We know Kp is equal to Kc into RT whole to the power delta Ng. So this is a very very important relation between Kp and Kc. Now the question, Kp by Kc is equal to RT whole to the power delta Ng. Okay, now the first equation given to you, N2 plus O2 2NO, whose delta NG is 0, so directly I am writing RT whole to the power 0, any to the power 0, nothing but what? 1. So the first Kp by Kc value is 1. So Kp by Kc value 1, we have how many options here? Option B is there, option C is there, and option D is there. 3 options we have. Okay, now come to next equation N2O4 gives 2NO2. N2O4 equilibrium 2NO2. What is the delta NG here? Delta NG equal to 2 minus 1, which is equal to 1. So directly we are writing Kp by Kc is equal to RT whole to the power delta NG. Now what is the RT value given in the question? 24.62 RT value given to you. Yes or no? Now next equation given to you, N2 plus 3H2 equilibrium 2NH3. Now here delta NG 2 minus 4, which is equal to minus 2. So shall I write Kp by Kc is equal to RT whole to the power delta NG, where delta NG value minus 2, so RT whole to the power minus 2, that is 1 by RT whole square. Okay, now what is the RT value given in the question? 24.62 whole square. Yes or no? That is 0.00165, which is nothing but 1.65 × 10⁻³. So if you see all these values, so the first value should be 1, second value should be 24.62, and third value should be 1.65 × 10⁻³. That is the option number C. Option number what? C, third option. Okay, now come to the next third question. It is also last year online question paper, 2019 CBT computer based test. Okay, now here ammonium hydrogen sulfide decomposition. Read the question. 5.1 grams of ammonium hydrogen sulfide is introduced in 3 liter evacuated flask at 327 degrees Celsius. 30% of the solid ammonium hydrogen sulfide, ammonium hydrogen sulfide decomposed to ammonia and hydrogen sulfide as gases. The Kp value for the reaction at 327 degrees Celsius is the question. R value 0.082 given to you. Molar mass of sulfur 32 gram per mole. Molar mass of nitrogen is given 14 gram. And hydrogen we know, that is 1. Okay, we have to find the Kp. Now, the solid NH4HS decomposes to give two gaseous substances, that is ammonia and H2S. Now, what is the molar mass of ammonium hydrogen sulfide? That is 51. Okay, now I am initially we are taking find the number of moles. How to find the number of moles of ammonium hydrogen sulfide? Given mass, that is 5.1 gram in the question, it is given 5.1 gram. Okay, molar mass is given, is calculated as a 51. So number of moles of ammonium hydrogen sulfide initially 0.1. Are you getting my point? Now when the system attaining the equilibrium, 30% of solid ammonium hydrogen sulfide undergo decomposition. That means if 100 moles are there, 30 moles will be decomposed. If 1 mole is there, 0.3 moles decompose. Yes or no? In 0.1 mole, how many moles decompose according to 30%? 0.03 moles will decompose. So 0.1 moles minus of 0.03 moles. So 0.03 moles, 0.03 moles. Are you getting my point? Now, finally, at equilibrium, total number of moles will be equal to 0.03 plus 0.03 is equal to 0.06. Remember, this is solid whose number of moles is not considered. Are you getting my point? Only for gaseous substance and aqueous solution. Pure solids, pure liquids, number of moles are not considered. Okay. Now what I am trying to calculate here, total pressure at equilibrium. Once we know the total pressure at equilibrium, we can easily find the Kp value. Okay. Now consider ideal gas behavior. So we are using ideal gas equation. What is the ideal gas equation? PV is equal to nRT. Now we have to calculate the total pressure of the system at equilibrium. What is the volume of the container given to you? 3 liters. Total number of moles 0.06, R value 0.0821, and the temperature value 600. Remember, temperature given in the degree Celsius, we have to convert the temperature into Kelvin by adding the 273. Okay. Now if you simplify this, you will get the total pressure at equilibrium will be 0.9852 atm. Okay. Now what is the Kp expression? In the last video I explained you how to write the Kp expression. Otherwise, in the previous videos you can see how to calculate the Kp Kc expression for homogeneous equilibrium, heterogeneous equilibrium. Okay. Directly we are using partial pressure of ammonia, partial pressure of H2S. So here partial pressure of ammonia P/2, H2S is also P/2. Okay. So directly we can write the Kp expression P² / 4. Okay. Now for simplicity, let's suppose it is assumed to be 1 atm. So you will get final answer 1/4, that is 0.25. This is not exactly approximate answer I am writing here. So 0.25 is the option number B. Are you getting my point? Not exactly, I am approximately calculating the answer. Okay. Now come to next question. It is also previous online question paper question. Now for the chemical reaction X gives Y, the standard reaction Gibbs energy value given to you, delta G naught value. What is the delta G naught value given to you? 120 minus 3/8 T. Okay. Let's suppose delta G naught value, let's suppose 0, then 120 minus 3/8 into T will be 0. From here 3/8 into T is equal to 120. So 3 ones are 3 fours are 12. Now T is equal to 320 Kelvin. Yes or no? Now at 300 Kelvin temperature, delta G naught value system equal to 0. Are you getting my point? Now that means the reaction at equilibrium mixture, the reaction existing at equilibrium mixture. Now here we are having different types of cases. First case, when the temperature exactly 320 Kelvin, then the delta G naught value become 0. That means you have both reactants and products. So what is the reactant here? X and Y product. Both X and Y exist at equilibrium. Yes or no? Let's suppose if the temperature assumed to be greater than 320 Kelvin, then obviously delta G naught value become negative. When the delta G naught value negative, the system move in forward direction spontaneously. The process will be spontaneous. Products are predominate over the reactants. Products are major. What is the product here? Y. So Y will be the major. Next, one more case, that is the third case. If the temperature value less than 320 Kelvin, then obviously delta G naught value greater than zero. Okay, that means this process will be non-spontaneous. This process will be non-spontaneous in forward direction, in which reactants are predominate. Okay, what is the reactant here? X. X will be predominate. Now, see the one by one option. First option, if the temperature is 315 Kelvin. 315 Kelvin means less than 320. Less than 320, X will be predominate. X will be predominate. Are you getting my point? Next, 280 also X will be predominate, because temperature should be less than 320, only reactant will be predominate. Okay, so product is not predominate, that is why is predominate in option B, that is not correct. And if the temperature is 350 Kelvin, 350 Kelvin means you have more than 320 Kelvin, that means products are predominate. What is the product here? Y. But the option has X. That is incorrect. And next one more is there. If the temperature is 300, that means again less than 320, that means X will be predominate, but option is given Y. So what is the correct option here? First up. Next one. For the equilibrium 2H2O, gives rise to H3O plus OH minus the value of delta G naught at 298 Kelvin temperature. Now here, first of all, the dissociation of water to give H plus and OH minus. H plus in water exists as a H3O plus ion. Now this is called dissociation of water. It is called what? Dissociation of water. The dissociation of water, the equilibrium constant will be 10 to the power minus 14, where at 298 Kelvin temperature. This is very important. When the temperature is room temperature, that is the 25 degrees Celsius or 298 Kelvin, the water dissociation equilibrium constant is 10 raised to minus 14. This is a fact based. So we have to remember the Kw. It is also known as a Kw, which is known as a ionic product of water. Okay, which you will learn in the ionic equilibrium topic. Okay, now here equilibrium value we know, now temperature we know, the delta G naught value, yes, how to find the delta G naught? From the thermodynamics, delta G naught value is equal to minus 2.303 R T log of equilibrium constant. Yes or no? So this is the Gibbs free energy change under standard condition. Gibbs free energy change under standard conditions. Okay. Now from here, we can calculate the delta G naught value minus 2.303 R value. In options, the energy value in terms of kilojoule. So I am taking the R value as a 8.314 whole divided by 1000, and temperature will be 298 Kelvin and logarithm of 10 raised to minus 14. Remember, 10 raised to minus 14, this is the dissociation of water. Water dissociation constant, ionic product of water. Okay. Now here, delta G naught value equal to, if you simplify this one, you will get 79.88 kilojoule per mole. Okay, that means approximately answer become 80. So that is the fourth option. This is also last year 2019 online paper question. Okay, from equilibrium chapter, chemical equilibrium chapter. Now come to next problem. Prove that pressure necessary to obtain 50% dissociation of a PCl5 at 250 degrees Celsius is numerically 3 times of the Kp. That means we have to prove that total pressure at equilibrium will be 3 times of the Kp. Now what is the equation for the decomposition of PCl5? PCl5 decomposes to give what? PCl3 and Cl2. This is a homogeneous gas phase reaction. Homogeneous gas phase reaction. Now in this reaction, we know how to calculate the Kp. I am directly using the expression Kp is equal to alpha square P divided by 1 minus alpha square. So this is a very important expression. We know how to calculate the Kp, Kc values in homogeneous and heterogeneous equilibrium. If you have any doubts, go watch the previous videos. Okay. Now here, what is the alpha given to you? 50%, that is 0.5. Okay. Now Kp is equal to 0.5 whole square into pressure, that is as usual 1 minus 0.5 whole square. Okay. Are you getting my point? Now here Kp will be equal to 0.5 whole square 0.25 into P. Here I am writing 1.5 into 0.5, a square minus b square, that is a plus b into a minus b. Okay, so finally you will get P by 3. By cross multiplication, P is equal to 3 times of the Kp, that is the equilibrium pressure will be equal to the 3 times of the equilibrium constant. Equilibrium constant. Okay. Now next question. 50% of CO2 will be converted into CO at equilibrium. Now the equilibrium pressure is given 12 atm. Then find the Kp value. Now here C plus CO2 equilibrium 2CO. Okay. Now here carbon is a solid, CO2 and CO are gases. Let's suppose initially we have P atm pressure of CO2. There is no carbon dioxide. When it is react with graphite, that is carbon, 50% of CO2 will decompose into CO. So I am subtracting minus of P by 2 because 50% of P, that is P by 2. So here you will get the P. So what is the total pressure at equilibrium now? The total pressure at equilibrium is equal to P minus P by 2 plus P. So overall total pressure at equilibrium become how much? 3P by 2, which is given in the question as a 12 atm. 12 atm. Okay. From here, what is the P value here? 8 atm. What is the P value here? 8 atm. Now what is the Kp expression? Partial pressure of CO whole square divided by partial pressure of CO2. Yes or no? Partial pressure of CO nothing but P. So P square. Partial pressure of CO2 will be P minus P by 2 will be what? P by 2. So I am writing here P by 2. So I am finally writing the final answer as a 2P. So the P value here 8 atm. So 8 to the 16 atm. Next question. The density of a equilibrium mixture N2O4 and NO2 at 1 atmosphere and 348 Kelvin is 1.84 gram per liter. Calculate the Kc expression. Now to calculate the Kc expression, we have to know the degree of dissociation. Unless until we do not know the degree of dissociation, it is not possible to calculate Kc or Kp expression. For such purpose, what happens? First of all, I am writing the equilibrium N2O4 equilibrium 2NO2. Okay. Let's suppose 1 mole of N2O4 initially I am taking, no NO2. At equilibrium, let's suppose alpha moles dissociated, so 2 alpha moles will be formed. Total moles at equilibrium total moles at equilibrium, which is equal to 1 minus alpha plus 2 alpha, which is equal to 1 plus alpha, which is equal to 1 plus alpha. Okay. Ab isme, in this what happens? First of all, we know degree of dissociation, alpha. So, here, molecular weight of the initial compound divided by molecular weight of the mixture, because at equilibrium we have both reactants and product, will be equal to accelerate 1 plus alpha into n minus 1. 1 plus alpha into n minus 1, where n is the number of moles of gaseous product obtained from the 1 mole of the gaseous reactant. So here number of moles of gaseous product obtained is 2. 2 minus 1 is 1. So 1 plus alpha. Are you getting my point? Now here, what is the initial molar mass? That is only N2O4, which is 92. So what is the equilibrium molar mass? So how to find the equilibrium molar mass? How to find the equilibrium molar mass? Here, density given to you. From the density data, we know density of ideal gas D is equal to Pm by RT. If the density mixture is given, then we can find the molar mass of the mixture at equilibrium. So, molar mass of the mixture at equilibrium will be density of the mixture at equilibrium multiplied by RT divided by pressure. Okay? What is the density given? What is the density given here? 1.84 given. R value we know 0.0821. Temperature is given 348 Kelvin and pressure is given 1 atmosphere. So after that you will get 52.57. Okay. Now what is the initial molar mass of N2O4? 92. Molar mass of mixture at equilibrium 52.57 will be equal to 1 plus alpha. From here, if you simplify, alpha value 75%. Alpha value 75%. Okay. Now, if the alpha value we know, 2 into alpha, which is 1.5, 1 minus alpha, which is 0.25. Are you getting my point? So, equilibrium moles we know. So, from which we can find the Kc expression. How? Concentration of NO2 whole square divided by concentration of N2O4. What is the concentration of NO2? 1.5. So, 1.5 whole square divided by, what is the concentration of N2O4? 0.25. 0.25. Are you getting my point? So the answer is 9. The answer become what? 9. The next question, calculate the Kp at 298 Kelvin for the gas phase reaction. Now in this gas phase reaction, what happens? This is related to thermodynamics chapter. In this what happens? Delta H0 values, formation enthalpy is given and entropy is also given. From these two data, first of all, you find the delta G0. Once you find the delta G0, then we can find the equilibrium constant. Yes or no? Now, here, what is the delta enthalpy of a reaction? Sum of the enthalpy of formation of products minus sum of the enthalpy of formation of reactants. We know in the chapter of thermochemistry, how to find the enthalpy of a reaction when the enthalpy formation data given to you. Okay, from here, what are the products here? CO2 and H2. Reactants are CO and H2O. Okay, now here CO2 enthalpy of formation minus 393.5. Hydrogen, elementary state, standard enthalpy formation of an element will be orbital assumed to be 0, that is given here, minus of standard enthalpy formation of carbon monoxide minus 110.5. minus of standard enthalpy formation of water will be minus 241.8 minus 241.8. Okay, now the standard enthalpy of reaction you will get minus 41.2 kilojoule. Okay, now 1 kilojoule is equal to 1000 joules, so shall I write 41,200 joules? 41,200 joules. Now similarly, entropy, standard entropy of the reaction, entropy of the products minus standard entropy of the reactants. Okay, now what are the products here? CO2H2. Now whose entropy standard condition given to you? 213.6 plus 130.6. this is the products, minus of reactants value given 197.6 plus 188.7. okay, now here this value minus 42.1 joule. Here the value will be joule, that's why I am converting the kilojoule into joule. Okay, after that there is a one more relation between change in Gibbs energy versus enthalpy and entropy of the reaction, which is the delta G naught is equal to delta H naught minus T delta S naught. This is the change in Gibbs energy in the standard condition. Okay, now what is the delta H naught? Minus 41,200 minus of 298 multiplied by minus 42.1. okay, so the value here minus 28,655 joule per mole per. Okay, now after getting the delta G naught value, we know one more relation, delta G naught is equal to minus 2.303 R T log of equilibrium constant. This is also important relation between the change in Gibbs energy in the standard condition, free energy versus the equilibrium constant. After that, delta G naught value minus, what is the delta G naught value here? Shall write log of equilibrium constant value directly, minus delta G naught whole divided by 2.303 R T. Okay, now minus minus of minus will get plus 28,655 divided by 2.303 R value in terms of joule 8.134 and the temperature is 298. Okay, now from here equilibrium constant, logarithm of equilibrium constant value 5.22, approximately you can take 5 also. From here the equilibrium constant value become 1.052 into 10 raised to 5. This is the very important question, because here there are 3-4 multiple concepts here. First of all, we have to calculate the enthalpy of the reaction, then entropy of the reaction, then standard enthalpy change of the reaction, after that equilibrium constant of the reaction. Okay, now next question, question number 10. 1 liter of a vessel contains 2 moles of each gases A, B, C, D at equilibrium. Okay, now already concentration of the species given at equilibrium, shall I write directly equilibrium constant, which is equal to product of the concentration of the products divided by product of the concentration of the reactants. Okay, from the law of mass action. Okay, what are the concentrations of each species at equilibrium? 2 moles. Container volume is unit volume. Okay, so the equilibrium constant value, what happens? 1. Now the question is, from the reaction mixture, if 1 mole of A and B are removed, then what about the K equilibrium? K k equilibrium independent on concentration of reactants and products. This is very important. We know which factors will affect the equilibrium constant and which factors do not affect the equilibrium constant. So the answer is, again, equilibrium constant is 1, because only k equilibrium depending upon the temperature for a particular balanced given equation. Okay, now in this question there are 3 graphs given, A, B, C. Okay, now the question, first question is, which curves give the above represent a very rare standard reaction at equilibrium? First of all, we have to know the relation between the standard Gibbs energy change versus equilibrium constant, that is the delta G naught is equal to -2.303 R T log of K equilibrium. Yes or no? Just now we told you. Now, here there are 3 cases. The first case, when the K equilibrium value greater than 1, then log of K equilibrium value log 1 0, log greater than 1 is equal to greater than 0. That means delta G naught obviously less than 0. The process will be spontaneous and equilibrium shift in forward direction. Okay, now case 2. In this case 2, when equilibrium constant is less than 1, then log of K equilibrium value negative, negative into negative positive, so that's why delta G naught value positive, the process become non-spontaneous in forward direction. That means this is spontaneous in reverse direction, backward reaction favors. And this is the third case, which is rare case. If the K equilibrium value assumed to be 1, then log 1 becomes 0, 0 into anything becomes 0, so delta G naught value 0, the process under equilibrium, the process under equilibrium. So this is a rare case where the equilibrium constant become 1. Okay, now out of these 3 graphs, if you observe carefully, in the first graph the concentration of products are predominating, that's why forward reaction takes place. That means this first graph corresponding to case 1. Okay, now come to graph number 3. The equilibrium shifted more towards reactant side. That means the process will be in the reverse direction. That means this will be the case 2. There is a special case, that is the case 3, where the concentration of reactants and products are, the ratio of the concentration of products divided by reactants, that is the K equilibrium value is 1. That means this is the equilibrium case. This is the case 3. This is a very rare case. Rare case. Okay. Now, which curve gives the above representation a very rare case? That means the curve number 2. That is the curve number, second curve. That is the answer B here. Okay. Now, next question. Which of the following curve give the above representation a standard reaction spontaneous in forward direction? Spontaneous in forward direction, case 1. Case 1 corresponding to which graph? A. So the answer become A for the 12th question. Okay. Now question number 13. Which curve give the above representation of a standard reaction for delta G naught value greater than 0? Delta G naught value greater than 0. Case 2 corresponding to graph number C. Graph number C. This is the answer C here. Now, which curve will give the representation, will give the equilibrium constant 1? Equilibrium constant 1, this is a rare case. That is the case 3. Case 3 corresponding to graph B. Case 3 corresponding to graph B. Are you getting my point? Now, question number 15. Here, there are two reactants A and B and two products C and D. Okay, now here equilibrium constant given to you 100. Okay, now if initially concentration of all the four species 1 mole per liter, 1 mole per liter, that means in the container both reactants as well as products present. Okay, let's suppose when the system attaining the equilibrium, x moles of A decomposes, according to which x moles of B also decomposes, according to which x moles of C and x moles of D will be formed. So initially already 1 mole x, 1 mole c, 1 mole d present. Now x mole c, x mole d added. So final moles at equilibrium 1 plus x for c and d. For a and b 1 minus x. Okay. Now if you apply the equilibrium constant Kc value, what is the equilibrium constant Kc? C into d by a into b. Okay. Now 100 is equal to, shall I write 1 plus x whole square by 1 minus x into 1 minus x whole square. From here, shall I write 1 plus x by 1 minus x is equal to 10. 1 plus x by 1 minus x is equal to 10. Are you getting my point? After simplification of this, you will get x value 9/11. Now the question is, what is the concentration of D at equilibrium? What is the concentration of D at equilibrium? Which is equal to 1 plus x. That is 1 plus 9/11, which is 20/11, which is 1.818. Okay, 1.818, option B. Now 16th question, we know the effect of temperature on the equilibrium constant. There are two graphs for exothermic and endothermic reaction. Now in this question, the graph corresponding to which reaction? Exothermic reaction. Do you know in exothermic reaction, as the temperature increases, equilibrium constant decreases? Now, ln equilibrium constant versus 1 by T. Now, you have straight line like this. Okay, this is corresponding to which reaction? Exothermic reaction. Now, in the diagram, so one graph is given, A graph, if you observe, this is corresponding to exothermic, and which is, and the graph B, which is parallel to A, this is also exothermic. So this is exothermic graph and this is endothermic graph. Why endothermic? Because on the x-axis 1 by T increases, T decreases, ln K decreases. That means K and T directly proportional. That is endothermic reaction. AB exothermic, option number B, second option is the correct answer. Now, question number 17. Now here, the percentage yield of ammonia as a function of time in the reaction N2 plus 3H2 2NH3, delta H value less than 0, that means it is a exothermic reaction. Pressure given P and temperature is T1 is given below. Okay, now if this reaction is conducted at same pressure P but T2 temperature, that means T2 greater than T1, that means we are increasing the temperature. Then what about the percentage yield of ammonia as a function of time is represented by? Now here, in generally, in exothermic reactions, as the temperature increases, equilibrium shift to backward direction. That means the percentage of yield will decrease. But initially, what happens if we increase the temperature, though there are factors which affecting the rate of a chemical reaction, which you will be studied in the chemical kinetics chapter, where the effect of temperature on the rate of a chemical reaction. Okay, Now, as the temperature increases, what happens? The rate of a chemical reaction increases. This is experimentally observed data. Okay. Now, as the temperature increases, initially the rate of a reaction increases. That means the percentage of yield of ammonia formation also increases. Okay. But after attaining the equilibrium, you are increasing the temperature, the equilibrium, what happens, shift to backward direction, because exothermic reaction, you are increasing the temperature, so backward reaction favors. That means here what happens, the percentage yield of ammonia will be decreases. Are you getting my point? Now here percentage of yield of ammonia decreases as the temperature increases. We have two options, option B if you observe, and option C if you observe. Temperature increases, the dotted line curve corresponding to low temperature and the solid wedge line corresponding to the high temperature. But the thing is, in B and C, in the C option, continuously what happens, percentage of yield decreases continuously with respect to T1 graph, T2 graph decreases. That means percentage of yield completely decreases from the beginning onwards. But in the graph B, if you see, in the beginning what happens, the solid line will be overcome the dotted line. That means the percentage of yield increases. After reaching the equilibrium point, that means the percentage yield will be decreases, because you are increasing the temperature and the system, that is the reaction is exothermic, that's why the percentage of yield will be decreases. That means finally the answer is second option. This is the previous IIT advanced question. Okay. Now here, initially on increasing of temperature, rate of a chemical reaction will increase, so percentage yield will also increase with the time. But at equilibrium, percentage yield at high temperature, which is T2, will be less as the low temperature, because the reaction is exothermic. Okay. Here one more question is there, question number 18. This is a previous question. The standard Gibbs energy change at 300 Kelvin for the process 2A gives B plus C. So the process given to you, 2A gives B plus C. First of all, I am writing the equation 2A gives B plus C. What is the standard change in Gibbs free energy value? 2494.2 joule. Okay. Now, first of all, from the delta G naught value, shall we find the equilibrium constant? Yes. How to find the equilibrium constant? Delta G naught value is equal to -2.303 RT log of equilibrium constant. Okay. Now from this expression, delta G naught value 2494.2 equal to -2.303. R value in terms of joules, I am taking 8.314 into temperature 300 Kelvin into log of equilibrium constant, which we have to find. Okay. So here log of equilibrium constant value, which is equal to -0.4341. From here the equilibrium constant value is 0.37. Now what is the actual expression for reaction coefficient? QC is equal to, what is the equation, B concentration into C concentration whole divided by A concentration whole square. Okay. Now what is the concentrations given? Concentration of A given 1/2, concentration of B given 2, concentration of C is given 1/2. So from these concentration values, we can find the QC value, B value 2, C value 1/2, whole divided by A value 1 by 2 whole square. So here the QC value how much? 4. What is the K equilibrium? That is the KC. Now QC and KC, this is also nothing but indirectly KC, equilibrium constant. Now here QC greater than KC, that means backward reaction favorable, reverse reaction favorable. Yes or no? Reverse reaction favors. So QC greater than KC, there are two options, C and D, but in the D option, reverse reaction, which is the correct option. Option number D is the correct answer. Okay. Now, come to one more last question. Here, we have I2 aqueous solution plus I minus, that is iodide ion in aqueous solution, when mutually combined to give triiodide ion, I3 negative ko triiodide ion bolte, theek hai? So all these species exist in aqueous medium. Okay, now in the starting there are 1 mole of iodine and 0.5 moles of I minus. Okay, when the system attaining the equilibrium, let's suppose X moles of I2 decomposes or react, according to which I minus X moles react, so X moles of I3 minus will form. Now, how to find the X value? After attaining the equilibrium, excess of AgNO3 added to the reaction mixture, which will give 0.25 moles of yellow color precipitate. What is the meaning of yellow color precipitate? Now in the system, I am adding silver nitrate in which Ag plus ions combining with I negative, I minus ions, they will form silver iodide precipitate. The silver iodide precipitate is a yellow color precipitate. Okay. Now Ag plus ions will be excess in the solution. Now come to I minus and AgI. If 1 mole I minus ions are there, then 1 mole of a AgI precipitate will be formed. Now here, how many moles of AgI precipitate is there? 0.25. So 0.25 moles of AgI precipitate, that means how many moles of Ag plus ions, how many moles of I minus ions will be present? 0.25 moles of I minus ions will be present at equilibrium. Are you getting my point? That means finally at equilibrium, number of moles of I minus ion, which is 0.5 minus x, which is equal to 0.25. That means x value is equal to 0.25. After getting the x value, 1 minus x value becomes 0.75 here, 0.5 minus 0.25, 0.25 here, x value 0.25 here. So we can calculate the K equilibrium constant, which is equal to I3 negative concentration divided by I2 concentration into I minus concentration. I minus concentration. Are you getting my point? After simplification, this one, that means I3 negative concentration, you have 0.25 whole divided by I2 concentration 0.25, I minus concentration, I2 concentration 0.75, I minus concentration 0.25. So the answer will be 100/75, which is equal to 4/3, nothing but 1.33. So this is the